As negotiators try to strike a deal to avoid another government shutdown, if you can believe it, President Trump is making his case by going right to the border today.
He will hold a rally tonight in El Paso, Texas, to insist on billions of dollars in border wall funding. This is after the mayor there, a Republican, said the administration should stop vilifying his town and visit it. Mayor Dee Margo writes, quote, "We in El Paso, Texas, are a community that transcends the border. While some are concerned about our proximity to Mexico, we choose to celebrate it. While others embrace building a wall, we remind them a fence already exists." So joining us now is El Paso Mayor Dee Margo. Good morning, Mayor, and thank you for being with us. As the president comes tonight, what's your message as you welcome him to El Paso?
Well, I've said for months, if you want to learn about the border, you need to come to El Paso. We are the largest U.S. city on the Mexican border, and we're kind of really one region of 2.5 million plus people. So I'm pleased he's coming in, and hopefully we'll get a chance to visit and talk about and see firsthand what the border really looks like and how we are so closely intertwined for almost 400 years between El Paso and Juarez.
As you're aware, that the president has used El Paso's experience to justify his demand for a border barrier, claiming that the wall there reduced crime. CNN fact-checked this, others have, and I'm going to put a graph up on the screen here that shows that, in fact, crime, violent crime in El Paso came down for years before a border wall decision in 2006, ticked up a bit around the time it was built in 2008. I'm just curious, because I know your position is to have a more broad discussion here, that barriers have their role, but it's not all about barriers. But this is a central part of the president's argument there, that you need the barriers, otherwise we're going to have a sort of wave of criminals coming across the border from Mexico. Is that connection, is that justification misleading in your view?
Well, what he was echoing in the State of the Union, and he was certainly correct at the end of his remarks about El Paso, that we are the safest city, but the prefacing remarks were he was echoing what had been said by our attorney general a few weeks ago in McAllen. That was wrong. If people had contacted me about our attorney general's remarks, I would have corrected it at that time as well.
You're talking about
You're saying the president is wrong. He was wrong in the State of the Union when he made this claim about crime rising there without the barrier.
Well, exactly. We were going back to 2005, one of the safest cities in the nation. The barrier went up and the fence went up, and it's only about 10 miles long, and the total fencing in the El Paso sector is about 78 miles, and it's not continuous. Now, it's part of the process for border security, but it's not the total panacea. But the remarks that the president made in the State of the Union were stated originally, almost verbatim, by our attorney general some weeks ago, and that's where the erroneous comments came from, that were not correct.
You're talking about Texas Attorney General Ken Paxton, and I'm just wondering if you reached out or your team reached out to the administration following the State of the Union to correct them on the facts there, and if so, what the response was.
We didn't directly reach out. We reached out to public media when everyone was commenting. I reached out on my own personal media, and I've responded every interview I've been requested since last Tuesday evening to correct the record. But when he comes in, if we can get a chance to visit, I'll reiterate that.
Mm-hmm. On the economic question, because you said in your op-ed that Mexico is actually an economic boost to your area there. Just explain that to folks at home who don't live in border communities and maybe hearing different stories about the economic positive economic benefits of what happens along the border. Explain that so folks understand.
Well, from a trading standpoint, which I've stated before, we have 82 billion. We're like the 10th or 11th largest trading port in the United States. We have 82 billion in goods, imports and exports between here and Mexico. We have 115,000 employees tied to the Maquiladora program with manufacturing in Mexico. There are 559,000 employees in northern Mexico tied to the Maquiladora program, and that's where you send raw materials from the United States over to Mexico and in Juarez, and they are assembled and manufactured, and they come back across, and duties are paid. on the labor value added. And that's been going on for many years. We are closely tied economically with Mexico. We have families on both sides, and we have the economics on both sides.
Mm-hmm. Mayor Dee Margo, we appreciate you taking the time. It's always good to have you on the air and kind of walk us through the facts along the border. We hope to have you back again.
Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you.